My name is Ruby L. Johnson. L is from Initial Lee.
I'd just like to ask you, what is the significance of this event that took place with the historical marker at the Cottage Inn restaurant in Liberty, Mississippi?
In memory of my father, Herbert Lee, for his contribution to the civil rights movement and being instrumental in helping to establish carrying African Americans to register to vote in 1961. This particular location on September 25th, 1961, my father was murdered. He was shot by a local state representative, E.A. Hurst.
Wow, that's amazing. Why was he shot? What was the reason behind him getting shot?
Well, the papers said, you know, different stories, and but we knew back in that time that blacks were supposed to be silent. Even though if you were able to be successful as far as having property or home, it wasn't supposed to go any further than that. The vote gave you a voice. It went beyond that. You're just having, being able to take care of your family, being able to be successful as a farmer. And Daddy was that. He could do those things. But the vote, he knew, was something that went so far beyond. It would give him a voice.
Mrs. Payne?
Uh-huh.
Yes, ma'am. What were you doing when it happened? You heard about your
son? I was watching TV as the word turned.
Yeah, it was like 20 minutes to one.
Yes.
When you got here.
Calvin, okay, Mr. Payne and Mrs. Payne, Lizzie Payne. So Larry was involved in the march. He did actually participate in the march.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was down.
He went to that march.
Yeah, because they had Doc King down there, and they had to get him out of there because they started looting down there.
Yeah, the people that weren't about the movement or about the march. They just want to stop.
Not to loot them stores.
Okay. And so what happened? So was the only person that ended up getting shot or killed that day? I mean, what was the circumstance? Like, what is the story?
Miscarriage of justice, what happened down there.
And that's why I'm not in Memphis today.
Uh-huh.
I don't even want to stay there no more.
Because the police, a lot of police came, people started gathering around, they started knocking people back with them nightsticks, hitting them nightsticks, trying to get them away from back.
And they wouldn't even let me touch Larry. That police put that shotgun into my stomach, told me to get back, nigga. Called me a nigga.
Did Dr. King reach out to you all at this time at the airway?
Yeah. He wanted to talk to me.
He died, so he
could talk to me. I don't know what he was going to say.
So Larry got killed that 28th, and Dr. King got killed April 4th, that next week.